As many of you know, I'm basically a pro tiny whoop FPV racing machine. Which is why taking the FPV component out of my tiny whoop FPV drone and throwing into the mini skiddy is the only logical thing to do. I can truly live out all of my mini skiddy dreams in first person.
Oh, this is so sick.
First, we've got to figure out how we're even going to do this. Luckily, I already have pretty much everything I need, including these FPV goggles. Though these are digital FPV goggles, meaning normally I would have to use a digital camera setup like this one from DJI, which while it is better quality, one, it would take up way more space. Two, it's just tremendously more expensive. And three, it would need some kind of fan on the inside of the mini skiddy to keep it from overheating. Now luckily, all of the cameras on my tiny whoop FPV racing drones are already analog, so I previously already had to invest in a system that I could view that analog footage through my digital goggles without having to reinvest in an analog pair of goggles. That way I just have one nice simple unit. So all in all, these antennas aren't even getting utilized, but everything's happening through this module. Now what I don't have is an extra analog camera, and I'm not quite desperate enough yet to rip one out of my old tiny whoop drone. At least not yet. So instead, I hopped on Amazon and found this ridiculously cheap analog camera, which I think is gonna work out pretty okay. You know, first thoughts are that it's actually surprisingly good quality. I would say that this is better than what I get out of my tiny whoop FPV drones. It's very fisheyed, which is good for the mini skiddy because we're gonna need as much wide angle as we can get. It seems to have pretty low latency, so I think this is gonna work pretty good. I don't know if you can see it or not, but I actually have the camera in there. It's at quite an awkward angle, but it's so wide angle, I feel like this is actually gonna work so, so well. I can see the bucket and the claw. Well, I can definitely see the claw and I can definitely see the bucket, but I think this is gonna work great as an FPV machine. Now the next step is designing the SOLIDWORKS file to hold it so that it's actually straight inside of the mini skiddy. So that shouldn't take too long, but here we go. Here's iteration one of the FPV camera holder. You probably can't see it very well, but with the power of OBS magic, now you can. So essentially all that's gonna do is the camera's just gonna sit right inside of this little opening, and hopefully it sits far enough forward so that it doesn't run into some of the PCB components on the actual camera board. But the only way to find out is to print it, so let's turn it into an STL file and send it to the bamboo. I've mounted the FPV camera inside of the mini skiddy using just a dab of hot glue to secure it to the actual fixture that holds the camera, and then that fixture is just resting in between these little holes that are inside the driver cage. So if I wanted to move the camera backward, all I'd have to do is kind of flex open the driver cage, and then I could shift this backward one slot. Same thing if I wanted to move it up or down, I just flex the driver cage a little and then move it down. Pretty nifty little design. Also, for the purposes of this test, I'm also gonna remove the claw. That way we just have maximum visibility of the bucket itself, because as you can see right now, the claw is just perfectly sitting in the way of the FPV camera. This wouldn't be a huge issue if I had made these holes inside the claw a little bit bigger, that way I could see through it. But judging by the fact that we're not ultimately gonna really need the claw for this test, I'm just gonna go ahead and take it off. Or better yet, I'll just take the camera out and put it in the mini skiddy that doesn't have a claw on it currently, and then I don't have to remove anything other than the camera, which is really simple. Watch this, ready? Hot swap, go! Oh, so quick, he's so speedy. Okay, maybe it's not as speedy as I thought it would be. And he's going. And he's, okay, it's still not quite as speedy as I want it to be. No, never mind, just cut. And just like that, the mini skiddy has been installed in, And just like that, the FPV camera has been installed in our other mini skiddy. That totally didn't take long at all. Smooth and effortless transition. Due to the fact that I'm gonna be wearing my FPV goggles and I'm not really gonna be able to see the buttons on my phone very well, which this makes it really hard to control the mini skiddy because I'm sitting there fumbling with which one's the arm up and down and the bucket tilt and all that, I'll actually be using my computer to control the mini skiddy, which luckily not only are the buttons clickable, but they're also bound to the arrow keys on the computer, as well as QWE and ASD for the bucket tilt, the arm up and down, and then the auxiliary. So for example, the arrow keys control the actual movement of the mini skiddy, and then W and S control the arm up and down, and Q and A step the bucket to different positions. And then E and D would be for the auxiliary, but I don't have an auxiliary attachment on there currently, so those don't do anything. If you've uploaded the code through your mini skiddy before, or you've received a mini skiddy kit from me, this already comes preloaded, so you don't have to do anything extra to actually have this work. You just gotta connect it to your computer, and you will be good to go. And I didn't refresh the page there. That's why that didn't work. And you will be good to go. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take this little guy for its first-person view adventure. Oh, this is weird. Oh, this is gonna work so well. Okay. I'm going to pick up the bucket. Oh, yes. Okay, hold on. Oh, this is sick. Oh, wait, I gotta be recording. Hold on. Back up the phone. Okay, we're now recording. I'm gonna bring this over here. Oh, this is so legit. Okay. Okay, I can't really see. Oh, now I can. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and dump this guy. Nice and easy, like. Okay, I can see the depth perception. Did I miss? Oh, I missed, didn't I? Oh, damn, okay. Oh, well, I'm going for the small cube.
Damn it!
Okay, we're going back for the other cube. With any great skill comes lots of practice. Come here, you. Go get this nice and right. Actually, I think I'm getting better. Okay, I've got the big cube. Okay. Let me go like this. Gotta get it over this lip. Aw, did you see those skills? Those were some professional skills. Okay, we're gonna try this one more time. Okay, we've got the cube. It's taking up a large portion. Oh, this is so sick. Okay. Okay. Now, I'm gonna bring it back down. How am I doing? Am I gonna get it? Third time is a charm. I've got the cube. I just hope that you guys can see me. See this gray cube here. Line it up. Okay, nice and easy. I do it? You know what? That totally counts. Here, I can even fix it. I can even fix it. Let me just, I'm just gonna give it a nice little nudge. Boom! I just did that in first person view. That was so legit. Okay, the next step now is, because if you have a mini skiddy with an FPV camera, you also have to have a mini environment to drive that mini skiddy in. So the only second logical thing to do is to build a mini warehouse for the mini skiddy. Here we are at the Mini Skiddy warehouse where we keep components such as ESP32 development boards, Mini Skiddy tires, a Professor Boots circuit board, and everything else related to a Mini Skiddy. Also, notice the new pallet loader attachment on the Mini Skiddy. I know it's not quite the most scale in comparison to the Mini Skiddy, but hey, it gets the job done, and threw that together real quick. Huge shout out to WimV on Printables for designing this whole warehouse setup. As you can see, it's pretty awesome. And then finally, before the showdown begins, if you'd like to support the channel, consider picking up one of these Mini Skiddy kits, which comes with everything you need to make one of these Mini Skiddies, minus the battery and charger. There's also a version that just comes with the electrical stuff, so that if you already have your own 3D printer, you can print out your own parts in whatever color you like, and then just combine the electronics to make yourself a Mini Skiddy. It goes a long way in allowing me to keep making projects and videos like this, and to all of you who already bought Mini Skiddies, I thank you so much. It absolutely blows my mind that people love the Mini Skiddy this much, and it's allowed me to reinvest a bunch of time back into making better components and parts, as well as other projects like the mini dump truck that will be coming out shortly. But also just subscribing and liking helps the channel a ton too. Now let's get these parts loaded into inventory before the big boss comes down and smacks us around. All right, everything's hooked up. I got video feed from the Mini Skiddy. I got controls from the Mini Skiddy. You know what time it is. It's time to do some pallet loading. Oh, this looks promising. Okay, I definitely have the tires. Just gonna lift them up. There we go. I think tires, what do you think? I think tires are a top shelf. Definitely a top shelf item here. I'm gonna get it all lined up. Bring the bucket down. Okay, that looks good. Get it on there. Here. No, not quite. Hold up. I can do this. Uh-oh. Hey, you know, that counts. That is, okay, tires are on. Let's see what's next. This is so weird. So awesome, though. I love this so much. Oh, I hit something. I don't know what I hit. Okay. Okay, this looks good. Lift the bucket up. I know that this probably isn't proper loading etiquette. OSHA, I'm sorry. Let me just lift the bucket down. Nice and easy. Okay. I think that ESP32s, they're a computer component, so we're gonna want them off the ground. I'm gonna put them up here. There we go. Okay, deposit, now back away. Oh, back away slowly. Let me just push that on. There you go, buddy. There you go, buddy. Get ready to get loaded. Ooh, these are heavy. Oh, this might just be like a... Oh, this is definitely just gonna be a... I'm just gonna try and slide these up. Oh, look at that. You know, I may not be forklift certified, but I am sure as heck skiddy certified. Oh, I almost had it. There we go. Claw has been successfully obtained. I think this is a medium shelf item for sure. We're just gonna bebop this guy right here. Or should we put it over here? Let's put it over here. There we go. Whoa. Whoa. Okay. This is not straight at all. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna fix it. Oh! That's how it is done. We just loaded this whole warehouse in first person view. I gotta say, I'm not gonna lie, I definitely practiced this a little bit, but nonetheless, that was extremely satisfying to do. With that, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a wrap. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the release of the mini dump truck coming out soon.